Going on holiday can be costly when you have to consider airfare, hotels, food, transportation, and entertainment. These days, the staycation has become a popular way to have a relaxing holiday without the financial stress. So today, we'll discuss how you can make staying home for the holidays feel like a real vacation. I'm Edric Mendoza, and this is On the Money. Joining us in this episode is Myra Mortega Calulo, features editor of femalenetwork.com. Hello, Myra.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Great, great, great. Thanks for being here.
Thank you as well. This
word is actually loaded, so let's get straight to it. Tell me, staycation. What in the world is a staycation,
All right. Myra? Okay, so staycation is actually, it's a broad term.
Right.
It could mean like, you know, just stay at home vacation. You could just stay at home and do
Put
lots of
activities.
Put those
words together, right? Stay at
home.
Okay.
But at the same time, it could also mean like going to nearby places and checking out local attractions like parks, museums. But it could also mean domestic travel. So you ditch all the hassle of like going abroad and all the expenses that come with it and just check out what the country has to offer.
Okay. So what staycations would you recommend here?
All right.
What exists? Are there categories? Because you said domestic, which is one option, right? And then there's other ones like going to your park, etc.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Well, there are lots of options. As I mentioned earlier, it's a very broad term. For our readers in Female Network, they like getting new ideas about how they could spend time at home. Like, you could have a movie marathon with your friends. You could have like a bake-off with your family or you could play sports with your kids.
Right.
So those are several things that you could do at home. At the same time, you could also check out the attractions that we have now in the city. There are lots of free activities that you could go to. So if you're like penny pinching, there are lots of options for you as well. So first off, if you're into the holiday spirit and you want your kids to just, you know, rev them up for Christmas.
Right.
Yeah, you could take them to Manila Pen where they could have a meet and greet with Santa for free.
Okay.
So
circa December.
Yeah.
Mid or closer to Christmas.
It's from December 20 to 25.
Okay.
Yeah. So
that's an option.
Yeah, that's one option. Or there's another event coming up this weekend at the Bonifacio Global City.
Right.
They have this thing called Passion Fest where they have lots of activities for kids,
That's
games.
Our hometown. Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah. You see. And they have activities for pets as well. And then they have chorales. On Sunday, they will be opening like their holiday festivities. So they have a grand lighting ceremony coming up. And there are going to be performances from various groups. So, and it's free again. So it's something that a lot of people.
So look out for options like that. So staycations are basically ways to have fun where you're at and not having to go very far.
Yeah.
Can you give us an idea of what staycations may cost? Let's say the example you gave of movie marathon at home.
Yeah, well.
With friends.
Yeah, for that kind of thing, you could just ask your friends to just bring their favorite DVD.
Right.
So.
Zero cost?
Yeah, zero cost.
Food, maybe?
Yeah, if you could have them to go, like, have food brought over, have a little potluck thing going on, yeah. It's another way to cut costs. If you're looking into, well, aside from the free events that we have here, if you're looking into other activities that you could do in the city, maybe a lot, like, as little as 500 pesos or 1,000 pesos.
Such as?
There's for another
it's
activity.
It's a great vacation, right? I mean,
yeah.
500 to 1,000 pesos only.
Yeah.
So, like?
Well, if you're planning to take your kids to, like, an edutainment.
Edutainment, session.
Yeah,
fun and learning combined.
Yeah, you could take them to the Mind Museum. They have this traveling exhibit going on until February. It's called the Biorhythm Exhibit. It's a really fun way of learning, like, how we hear things and how our brain processes information. Stuff like that.
And they even give student discounts, right?
Yeah, they do.
So that's a great perk. My kids went there. They loved especially the play area nearby.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a good example. Staycation.
And it's like around, if you go to the exhibit alone, it's 200 pesos. If you want to go to the museum as well and have a tour for 3 hours, that's an additional 600. So it's not that costly. If you're planning to visit like the nearby provinces, you have a bit more.
Sure.
But not as much as like when you're going abroad.
Right.
So,
what if I am, yeah, so since you mentioned the provincial areas, what if I'm based in the provincial, like I'm based in Cebu or somewhere in the Visayas or in Mindanao, what staycations are options for them there?
All right, okay. I suggest that you look for the off-beaten tracks, you know, I'm like, for Cebu, you go to the city, but a lot of people just go there and not think of, you know, the other locations that you could stay in there and the activities that you could do there. Mm-hmm. There's one resort in Moalboal, Cebu. Mm-hmm. It's called Halimana Beach Resort. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's a very warm and cozy place that you could, you and your friends could hang out in. It's like a place where you can relax. It has faces the beach. Mm-hmm. You have lots of activities that you can do. And I guess for an overnight stay, it's just around 3,000 pesos or a bit more. So it's not that costly as opposed to like going abroad for
clearly. Yeah. Give me examples of more staycations at home. Like let's say a family instead of going out, because we gave the movie marathon example of friends coming over. But what about a family that decides maybe we can just stay home? You have ideas there?
If you're looking into like a family activity, one way to bond with your kids is to take out the board games from the shelves.
So that's a staycation.
Yeah,
wonderful.
That's
so we're doing staycations quite a lot. Okay.
If you're planning to do something more creative, maybe you could take up a scrapbooking project with your kids.
Sure.
It's a way of like telling them the family history. Memories captured on film, and at the same time, you know, it lets them be creative as well.
Right. So I think the question is, if a person is not creative, because it seems like staycations require a sense of creativity and resourcefulness, is there anywhere they can go to sort of start getting ideas from? Is there a staycations.com, for example?
Well, in Female Network, we have lots of tips for people who are looking into suggestions for spending time at home, an entire weekend at home. So it's not just relegated to like the creative types.
Yes. Okay.
You could do lots of things at home, such as, you know, take up a new hobby that you're interested in, or play sports with your kids. So
I think you just need to be able to experience it one time, and then it'll start your creative juices. Pwede pala to. I can do this with my kids, or I can do this with my friends, and then keep going. What about domestic travel? So you said that's kind of staycation-ish, right? You want to talk about a little bit more about that?
All right. Well, for domestic travel, well, we have our forums called Girl Talk, and a lot of our members really share ideas on how we could cut costs. Well, I guess it depends where you're planning to go. Some travel agencies offer like an overnight stay in Iloilo for like 1,500 pesos per person. So if you get like a budget fare, it's gonna cost around 3,000 pesos or less. A lot of our girl talkers, that's what we call our forum members, they suggest that, you know, you bring a lot of friends with you so you can cut costs. And they also give a lot of recommendations like, which is the best place to stay in, or which travel agency gives you the best bang for your buck.
Right.
So
it's good to go into networks like that to find out, right? I mean, don't go at it solo.
Yeah.
Okay. Any key spots that staycationists should be looking for, let's say, in the domestic area, I mean, in the vicinity of the general Philippines?
Well, in our forums, a lot of our members are really into checking out spots in Bicol, like Karamoan, the CWC complex.
Right.
And, well, of course, you have, like, the trademark tourist spots like Boracay, Puerto Galera, and Palawan. But they're also interested in visiting spots like Sagada, Siquijor, Batanes. So, well, the thing about staycation is that, I guess the beauty of it is that you're not limited to just one option. Mm-hmm. So there's no really like a staycation
official
perfect
staycation spot,
right?
Yeah.
So it really depends on your preference and your budget. So as long as you have a specific activity in mind or a specific location in mind, and you're working under a tight budget, I think any place or any activity will do for a staycation.
Right. So if we were to break it down into steps into creating the perfect staycation, right? The first step you're saying is know what you want to do.
Yeah.
And maybe know who you want to do it with.
True. Yeah.
And then the next step would probably be looking for a budget.
Yeah.
And then that's where you put creativity together now. Look at sites, look at networks so you can come up with that. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. It really helps if you do a lot of research. Because there are lots of resources online, like
such as apart from the female network that you mentioned.
You could check out local travel agencies. They have
local
now,
travel agencies.
If they don't have websites, they probably have Facebook pages that you could like and you could get information from. So yeah, make use of the internet.
If a person actually put in the word staycation Philippines, would they get anything that would help direct them in those in that way?
Yeah, I think.
Maybe we could try a little later, right?
Yeah,
Staycation Philippines. Okay. So the general range of a staycationist can be anywhere as little as 500 pesos.
Yeah, or for free.
Is there a cap? Yeah. Like if you spend more than this amount, that's already a full vacation. What does a staycationist typically spend?
Maybe let's say around 3,000 to 7,000 pesos.
Per person.
Yeah.
That's still staycation caliber.
Yeah, for like a weekend trip. We're talking about like 2 days, 3 nights kind of thing.
Okay.
Because if you compare it to the cost of like going abroad, you'd spend more than 10,000 pesos or even 20,000 pesos. Yeah, so it's a really big difference from...
Okay, and more of the people that you have come across in your network are moving towards staycation. Is that what people are seeing now?
Yeah, actually, it's good that staycation became like a buzzword recently because
tell me the history. What happened?
It became popular around 2007, 2008, when the financial crisis hit the States. And
necessity is the mother of invention.
Yeah,
right?
But you know that, I mean, they love traveling, is ingrained in their culture. Mm. And if you can't travel abroad, might as well check out what your country has to offer, right? Or the local attractions in your hometown. Mm-hmm. So it became popular around that time. And then the budget hotels, the budget airfares started sprouting after that. So we caught on the buzz and now it's popular here.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Well,
we're going to have more questions for you in a bit.
All
right. But right now, we're going to take a short break. So stay with us. On the Money, we'll be right back. Welcome back to On the Money. Time now for our daily dose of Salve Says with Salve Duplito.
Buying a house is a big financial milestone in every person's life. And if you're not careful about this very emotional purchase, it can ruin your finances.
These days, the interest rates of mortgage loans can go down to as low as 6%. I haven't seen this kind of rate in my lifetime. So if you have the cash and the income, buying a house now is really good timing.
But buying a house just because of low interest and sometimes 0% down payment is a big mistake. There are hidden costs to home ownership that can trip up your budget. Before you know it, you're barely able to make the monthly payments. And this high expense will eat everything in your cash flow.
And this means you will be forced to stop investing. By the time you need the money for healthcare and retirement, what do you have? A big old house that has eaten up all your income, plenty of good memories, yes, but little else. You ask, what are the hidden costs of home ownership? You have property tax, fire insurance, mortgage redemption insurance, and sometimes hefty home association dues. For sure, it will be a bigger house than the current one you're living in, so your utility bill will get bigger. For the first 6 months, I bet that you will not be able to resist pouring love into your new home. You will be buying new appliances, redesigning the living room, and all that jazz. After that, the monthly maintenance of running your house will kick in. Busted pipes? There's no landlord to call. So here are some numbers to help you determine if you really can afford to buy that home you've been eyeing. Add 50% to your mortgage to determine the real cost of home ownership, including those hidden costs we discussed earlier. Let's say your monthly mortgage is 30,000 pesos. That means you have to budget 45,000 monthly. The next step is to get that figure, 45,000, and determine whether there is room in your monthly cash flow for a housing expense of that size. As a rule, your maximum housing expense should not be more than 28% of the family's monthly income. This means you need to be earning at least $160,000 after-tax money to afford this kind of monthly housing expense.
But wait, we're not done yet. We have to figure out if your mortgage can push you over the edge, what with the other debts you might be currently paying. And we have to be really honest here. You have to list down all the credit card and personal loans and other debts you need to pay on a monthly basis.
Finding your debt-to-income ratio will do that for you. Others say it shouldn't be more than 36% of your monthly salary. I am more conservative, and I believe payment for all kinds of debt should not be more than 1/4 of your monthly earnings.
So list down all your debt obligations, and I mean all. Don't fudge the numbers.
If your $30,000 mortgage payment added to all of those debt that you pay monthly add up to more than 25% of your monthly cash flow, you're in trouble. Either postpone buying that house until you fix your finances, or buy a much smaller one.
Buying a house is fulfilling, but you have to do it right. Owning a house you can't afford is the single biggest mistake you can make in your lifetime.
Still with us is Myra Mortega Calulo, features editor of femalenetwork.com. She will answer some of the money questions you sent us via email, Twitter, and Facebook. Mel, what questions do we have for staycationists and ourselves today?
Hi, Myra.
Hi.
Our first question comes from Sally, who says, I keep hearing about staycations, but how do I find out about the free activities I can do with my family? We have two small children aged 2 and 5, so I need to keep them entertained.
All right. Well, I would definitely suggest that you go online, do some research, ask for recommendations from your friends. I mean, word of mouth recommendation is a great way to start out. So, yeah, just go online. There are lots of things that you could do here. If you could check out the forums, if you could check out various websites.
Okay. So, how do you find out about the free activities? You had told me. I think we were chatting earlier, and you'd mentioned there was the Ayala Triangle, the lights show. I mean, what are the free things, let's say here in Metro Manila, what are some of the free activities?
So as I mentioned earlier, you could check out BGC for their holiday festivities. You could also, as you mentioned, also earlier, you could go to Ayala Triangle Gardens. So you could check out their lights and sound show.
What about in Quezon City, the north?
Around the north area, you could probably check out Trinoma. It's like a north version of the Ayala Triangle Gardens music and light show. It's basically created by the same team. So you could just go there and feel the holiday vibe.
Are there websites to find out though about these free activities? Where should people look?
All right. Well, in femalenetwork.com, we compile a lot of events, upcoming events that our readers might be interested in. So you could just go there. Our channel is called FN Radar. Just check out the events, sales, or upcoming activities that you might be
interested in. And it's nationwide.
Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah. Okay, that's good for other viewers. Now, Christine asks, I always go overseas for a holiday because I love the new experiences of traveling to a foreign country. How can I possibly replicate that with a staycation?
All right. In a staycation, it's like you're a tourist in your own country. Because, well, especially in the Philippines, we have like 7,107 islands. And you couldn't just check all of them out at the same time or even in your entire lifetime. So I think like if you're going for the touristy experience.
That might be a challenge for someone, huh? Yeah. Let's go hit all 7,000,
So I guess you could still replicate that here. I mean, if you're used to, for example, just living in the city, checking out rural areas might be quite a refreshing thing for you. So.
Okay, so going to your hometown, let's say you've left the province and you've lived in another city for 10 years. Going to your hometown, that counts as a staycation?
Yes, it does.
Okay, nice. Now Scott asks, I'm a very outdoorsy person and I'd like to go on a more active long weekend, either out of town or in town. Any tips on how I can do this without spending too much money?
All right. Okay. You could check out Nuvali and Laguna.
Yes.
Where you could go. Yeah, you could go biking, you could run with your friends, you could check out their man-made lake and have lots of activities there. So even if you're an outdoorsy person, you don't have to spend that much to just enjoy your hobbies.
What about like water sports closer to home, so you don't have to fly to Boracay or you don't have to fly to Palawan? I mean, what places that, let's say, closer to Metro Manila could you go to?
Well, particularly in the Luzon area, you could check out Bicol.
Mm-hmm.
Camsur is getting really popular nowadays, and you could check out like the water sports activities there.
Right.
Okay.
What about Taal? We brought some people from abroad. You know, we said, hey, you can climb a volcano. You know, and it's an interesting trip going up there. You think that's a drive away?
Yeah, it's very close.
You don't have to fly. Yeah.
Yeah, and you can do lots of activities.
Staycation worthy, right?
Yeah.
Are there good hiking spots around here? Because there seems to be a lack of hiking spots, or I don't know where to go.
Yeah. Well.
There are a number, yeah.
Yeah, there are a lot of hiking spots that you could go to. You could try out Mount Pulag.
Yes,
a lot of my mountaineer friends, they really recommend it for like the hiking newbies. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So.
And you can bring your dog with you.
Yeah, you can.
Are there dog-friendly places? There's a lack of dog-friendly hotels. I found
a few.
But you know, how difficult is it? You want to go on a vacation or a staycation with your dog.
Yeah, well, I guess in the city you could take them to UP. You could jog with your dog.
Okay.
A lot of, the people in the community there bring their dogs every Sunday. And just it's like a pet fair there every Sunday. you could also go to BGC or Eastwood if you want to take your dog out for a walk. So
They don't really like them off the leash, though.
Yeah.
They always freak out when your dog's off.
Because they don't know what it's going to do, right? Tight spaces, maybe, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but, you know.
So, yeah, go outdoors. Go to the Batangas area, that area, generally north. Sorry, south as well from Manila.
Yeah,
you have options there.
Anyway, the next question comes from Carl, who asks, is a staycation really cheaper than a budget flight to Hong Kong or Bangkok? I'm planning on going there over the Christmas holidays, but may reconsider if there is a huge cost difference, since my pockets tend to be empty after the Christmas season.
All right. Well, I think that there are a lot of budget airfares nowadays, but the thing is, it doesn't end there. When you're going abroad, you have to take into consideration your accommodations, the places that you want to go to. So having a staycation is definitely a cheaper alternative than going abroad.
Okay, so he could actually save $10,000 or more?
Yeah, as much as 10,000 pesos or even more. So.
And Myra, does it make sense also that, you know, the beauty of a staycation is the purpose, right? For example, we like being and having staycations when everyone's out and it's crazy and there's so many people. Enjoying it just in the home or somewhere nearby would be less stressful, right?
Yeah, that's
sense?
True.
So for this guy, you know, maybe he has to consider, you know what, why do you want to go on a vacation? Do you want to be around other people and do these things, or do you just want nice, quiet fun with some people?
Yeah, that's true.
Does that make
sense? It gives you a lot of leeway to do the things that you want to do. Like, for example, if you're an outdoorsy type of guy, then you have to go to a place where you could do exactly just that. Mm-hmm. But if you're going to another country and you're limiting yourself to the tourist spots, it doesn't give you that much freedom.
There you go. Is it possible to take a day staycation?
Yeah,
right? Just one day go off? Yeah.
You don't have to spend overnight in another locale to enjoy it.
Are they becoming more popular here? Or
they
is it still a relatively new thing, the staycation?
Not really. A lot, well, for our readers, a lot of them really like exploring their options for staycation. I mean, well, there are still people who like traveling abroad, but, well, having a staycation is a more convenient way to enjoy your weekend. So.
Of course. And what about if you decide, okay, I'm going to treat myself. I won't stay at home. I'll stay in a hotel.
Nearby,
Nearby. Yeah. I mean, is that also still a cheaper alternative?
Yeah, it is. Because, well, for one, you don't have to worry about airfare costs or other transportation costs.
Mm-hmm.
You're still in a familiar area, but you're not at your home. So you get to relax. So,
yes. There is room service.
Yeah.
They take care of you, right? Yeah, yeah.
And you really, you're in a hotel, you're in another place, so much better. Where can you get special deals on hotels?
Before you jump into those like coupon offers, you better check out first like if the site is or the group is very reliable. There are a lot of good websites that offer great deals, but at the same time, you also have to be very cautious about it. So it's best that you get recommendations from your friends or from the people you trust first.
Okay. And I guess, I mean, you can ask hotels if they're offering any special deals.
That's true. Yeah. That's true.
Anyway, thank you. Send us your money questions via email or through Facebook and Twitter, and we'll try to answer them in our upcoming episodes or on our next Q&A Friday.
So, staycationists all around here, clearly. I love this. I love staycations. Our family loves it. So, it's been a great show. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. That's
our show today. I'm Edric Mendoza. Join us again tomorrow for more talk and tips so you're always right on the money.